Now, we use decibels in all sorts of things. So if you're into science, you're doing an exam or whatever else, and you like the idea of understanding what decibels is, we're going to do this in about 5 minutes. So strap in, the easy way to understand decibels. So decibels have got an interesting history. So Bell Laboratories, I mean, this is going back like 100 years, when they first had telephones. Bell had something called a standard cable mile, or a mile of standard cable, SCM. I think it was SCM, standard cable mile. And it was generally accepted you had a loss on a telephone. And when the customer noticed enough of a loss, that was one bell. One bell of loss. Effectively, what they discovered, it was not enough granularity. I sounded like Mike then, didn't I? M0MSN. Sorry, Mike. There wasn't enough granularity, so they cut it into tenths. Decibel. Okay, so when we write decibel, it's a small d for the tenth, and then a big B for bell. Bell Laboratories, decibel. Okay, now we use the term dB in a lot of things. Optical glass will have dBs. Radar reflectivity uses the term dBs. In radio, we'll use dBs. Hi-fi systems, public address systems, it's all dBs. But we use dBs to reference, to understand how loud or more powerful or how clear the glass is. We use that. Let's just do a quick table to understand what we mean by dB. So if something is 0 dB and we double the volume, all right, we have increased it by 3 dB. And if we double it again, we've increased it by 6 dB. So every time we double something, or 3 dB, let's do it backwards. So every time we add 3 dB, we're doubling. 3 dB. Every time we add 3 dB, we're doubling something. But if we've got something that is currently at 13 dB and the something else is 16 dB, well, that's actually twice as powerful or clear or reflective or whatever else. Now, very often when it comes to dB, we will use it to reference against something known. So for instance, in radio circles, we might have something called an isotropic radiator, which is infinitesimally small dot, which doesn't exist in real life. It's just a bit of fun. It exists as a theoretical point, and that point will distribute RF, the radio signals, like a sphere, like a globe. All right, but we use that to reference as an imaginary piece of data to reference, say, a dipole, which is, let's say, a wire where most of the RF will be radiated perpendicular to the wire. So we will use the term dBi, maybe, when we are trying to reference one antenna against another. So if we've got a dipole, now a dipole in free space, at the maximum, on its outside of the donut of the dipole, will have a gain over an isotropic dipole, dBi, of around 2 dB. So we very often shorten that to say this antenna has a gain of 2 dBi. That's what it means, right? However, there's other ways we can use this dB. So we could have, let's say, a better colour, an interesting colour. Oh, there's a purple. We could have watts. Watts is power, isn't it? So we could have another system where we have D. It's not working very well. Go blue. Of dBw. It's a capital W because Mr. Watt. Okay, dBw. And that's reference to 1 watt. So if we have something of that is 1 dBw, means nothing so far until we find out that we've got this thing, this device, which is producing 4 times the amount of power, which will be 6 dBw. The suffix that we use at the end of these is determining what we're trying to reference it to. The easy way out of this is to say that if something's at 0 dB, 3, 6, 9, 10, 13, 16, what the hell am I doing? So that is double 3. So that's times 2. That's times 2 again. That's times 2 again. That happens to be times 10. So the quick way, if you're trying to work out how much power, if somebody says you are allowed 13 dBW, you go, oh, 13 dB, oh, that's here. So that's times 10 plus, there's another 2, because 13 minus 10 is 3. 13 is going to be is another 2 again. So if you've got this calculation to make in your head, you'll go, oh, right, so 10 dB is times 10. 13 dB is another 2 again. So 2 tens are 20, so it's 20 times the power. Have I confused you now? Hopefully not. That is a quick skim round what the hell decibels are. All right, so stick around if you want any more of this science. In the meantime, enjoy your science, enjoy your world. I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now. Some different colours. Lovely. Don't use green on a whiteboard with people, by the way, because it doesn't show up very well. Blue, red, and black will be fine.